We will move for the second paper. Surgery for insulinomas, a single unit experience. Authors are Jayasingha R, Subhasingha D, Sivaganesh S. Paper will be presented by Jayasingha R, Department of Surgery, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo.
Good afternoon. Firstly, I would like to thank the SLMA for giving me this opportunity to present. So today I'll be talking to you on surgery for insulinomas. So insulinomas are the commonest pancreatic neuroendocrine tumors, and they are also the commonest cause for endogenous hyperinsulinemic hypoglycemia. However, they are pretty rare, with an incidence of about 4 per million in the population. Most of them are solitary. And interestingly, 10% of them are multiple, 10% are malignant, and 10% are associated with multiple endocrine neoplasia type 1 or MEN type 1 syndrome. Although they classically present with symptoms of the Whipple's triad, they can present with a variety of other symptoms ranging from hypoglycemic seizures, coma, to cardiac arrest. The definitive treatment for insulinomas is by parenchyma sparing surgical excision. And the surgical procedure is largely determined by preoperative localization, which is often quite challenging in these patients. So the objective of our study is to outline the management of insulinomas in a tertiary hepatopancreaticobiliary surgical unit. So we did a retrospective analysis of patients who operated at our unit from 2012 to 2020. And the slide gives you the clinical and the biochemical criteria that were used to reach a diagnosis of insulinoma. And as I mentioned earlier, the choice of surgical procedure would largely depend on the preoperative localization, which would provide us information on the location of the tumor, the size of the tumor, and the proximity of the tumor to the pancreatic duct. So this is an outline of the demographic characteristics of our patients. So we included 6 patients in our study, out of which 2 patients had insulinomas associated with MEN type 1 syndrome. And all of the patients presented with hypoglycemic and neuroglycopenic symptoms. However, half of them presented early and the other half presented late. So we used both invasive and non-invasive methods of localizing insulinomas. And as you can see, cross-sectional imaging, mainly CECT, helped us localize most of the tumors in these patients. However, we had to complement it with invasive investigation methods such as selective arterial calcium stimulation test, intraoperative ultrasound, and endoscopic ultrasound. A few words on the selective arterial calcium stimulation test. So this is an invasive investigation used to localize insulinomas. And these arteries would be cannulated under fluoroscopic guidance. And a 10% solution of calcium gluconate would be injected onto each artery. And samples for insulin assay would be obtained from the right hepatic vein. And as shown in this example, this patient shows a positive selective arterial calcium stimulation test, which indicates a more than 2-fold rise of baseline insulin concentrations, which isolates his tumor to the distal body and the tail of pancreas because it is only in the region of the proximal and the distal splenic arteries. So this is an illustration of the surgical procedures that our patients underwent, and the 2 MEN1 syndrome patients additionally underwent foregland exploration, total parathyroidectomies, and hemigland reimplantation. So these are some of the intraoperative illustrations of the surgical procedures. So encircled are the insulinomas. So this is central pancreatectomy, and this is enucleation. This is spleen-preserving distal pancreatectomy. And this is the near total pancreatectomy. And this is one of our MEN1 syndrome patients who additionally underwent a total parathyroidectomy. So the major causes of morbidity of our study were mainly because of grade B and grade C pancreatic postoperative pancreatic fistulae, diabetes, and also one of our MEN1 syndrome patients had a prolonged ICU stay with several complications. All of the tumors were histopathologically benign, and with no tumor recurrence to date. So in conclusion, cross-sectional imaging was the key to preoperative localization of insulinomas. However, it had to be complemented by invasive investigations such as selective arterial calcium stimulation test and intraoperative ultrasound. And the surgical strategy is largely determined by preoperative localization. And post-operative pancreatic fistulae was a major cause of morbidity in our study. Thank you.
Thank you. Now the paper is open for these questions.
Well, in our study, out of the invasive and the non-invasive investigations that we used, mostly cross-sectional imaging helped us localize most of the tumors. However, we had to use invasive studies like selective arterial calcium stimulation test and all that.
The conclusion, that is what you did.
Yeah.
Now you can draw up conclusions. Now, are they standard conclusions? What is the rest of the world does? So is it different to what the others do?
Most of them, we have to use both invasive and non-invasive studies. However, invasive studies are used when non-invasive studies fail to give the provide localization of these tumors. That's the standard practice.
So did you find anything different in the standard practice with your cohort?
No, not really.
Can do larger number, like I think you are the one of the highest number stations, to give some national plan.
Well, we have to, in a future study, maybe yes. That's a good improvement.
Thank you very much.